What's going on, everybody? In this video, I'm going to quickly show you how to set up Touch Portal with OBS. We're also going to take a look at setting up Touch Portal for a dual PC stream setup, so you won't have any more questions when setting up Touch Portal with OBS in any of the ways that you need it to function. With that being said, we're going to jump right into this video. In order to connect Touch Portal to OBS, you need a way for the two applications to communicate with each other. The way that communication happens is with a WebSocket plugin that's built on the OBS forums. The first thing you'll need to do is make sure you download and install the WebSocket plugin into OBS. The link for the WebSocket plugin is in the description below. If you have any questions with the installation of this plugin, feel free to hop in my Discord server with any questions you have. After you've installed the plugin, make sure you restart OBS in order for it to pop up on your OBS application. On OBS, you'll find all the settings for the WebSocket server plugin in the tools tab at the top left and down on the WebSocket server settings. You'll want to make sure that the WebSocket server is enabled and go ahead and leave that server port at 4444. That will be the default for the Touch Portal setting. Now, if you take a look at your Touch Portal application, go over to the settings on the top right, you will find the OBS settings in the OBS tab. I suggest enabling the auto connect feature so that Touch Portal automatically connects to OBS every time you open the application. Another thing you can do on the General tab is start the application at Windows boot. This way, every time you open your computer, Touch Portal opens as well. If you're using a dual PC stream setup and you want to operate the OBS on your streaming PC from Touch Portal, it's quite easy to do. It just requires an additional step. You want to make sure you download and install that WebSocket plugin on the OBS of your streaming PC as well. Once you have that WebSocket plugin installed on the streaming PC, what you'll need to do is grab the IP address of that PC. You can grab your IP of the streaming PC by navigating to your network and internet properties on that PC. So if you click on the Wi-Fi and view the Wi-Fi settings and then go to the properties of that Wi-Fi, you'll find an IPv4 address. You want to copy that IPv4 address. Once you have the IP address, you'll head over to Touch Portal, go to your settings, and back to the OBS tab. On the OBS tab, what you'll notice is you have an IP address section here. Just paste that IP address in there, hit save, and you should be able to connect to the streaming PC. That's all that's required to get OBS functioning with Touch Portal. You've successfully installed the WebSocket plugin and have it working. Now I'm going to show you some basic features that you can do with Touch Portal now that you have it set up with OBS. If you're interested, I've actually created a Twitch page template that's available for download to import into Touch Portal. I suggest watching this video I did that I will link in the description, where I show you how to set up a Twitch page and a VoiceMeeter page if you're a user of both of those applications. When you open Touch Portal for the first time, you will be defaulted on the main page of your Touch Portal device. The main page is going to be your central hub of all your buttons. In order to get to a different page on your device, you need to create a button that will navigate to a different page. As you can see on the bottom right here of my main page, I have three navigation buttons. One's to go to my next page, one's to go to my VoiceMeeter page, and one is to go to my Twitch page. This is so I can access the other pages that I have on the application: the Francois Studio Mixer, the Francois Studio Twitch page, and the Twitch channel rewards. It's quite easy to set up any button you need in Touch Portal. If we take a look at my Photoshop button here, as you can tell, there are three tabs. You have on press, on event, and on hold. On the on press tab, you will create actions that interact with your PC from the action menu on the left. So if I were to create a start application action, I could start an application by pressing this button. And that is what I've done for the Photoshop application. As you can see here, it opens the Photoshop application when I press this button. Obviously, there's a lot more you can do than starting an application with Touch Portal. You have all kinds of different things. You have logic statements, you have HTTP GET and POST and PUTS, you have visual changes, media functions, OBS settings, Twitch settings, etc. Many, many things you can do using Touch Portal. The on event tab is where event changes will take place, whether that event change is a visual change with the button itself or events like redeeming channel points on your Twitch channel. And last but not least, the on hold tab is going to be actions that are activated by holding down on the button from your device. Once you break down everything that is Touch Portal, it's not that complicated and it's a very, very powerful application. I want to show you some of the basic functions that you have with Twitch, since this is a Touch Portal slash OBS setup video. If we head over to my Francois Studio Twitch page, you'll see all the buttons that I have open when I am streaming. You have a lot of basic functions here, like scene switches, moving my camera around the stream, pause and play functions for any media that I have playing. You have things like creating a clip, creating a stream marker, or even playing an ad on the stream, starting and stopping the stream, or starting and stopping the recording. And these down here are channel points, redemption events. For this video, I'll show you how to create a streaming on and off button. It's quite simple. What you want to do is hover over one of these black boxes, one of the empty buttons that you have on Touch Portal. Simply just click it. Pretty simple. In the action menu on the left, we're going to scroll down until we find our OBS category. The action that we're going to create is set streaming state. So when we press this button, it will start the stream, but we want to make it to where when we press the button again, it'd also shut off the stream. So what we can do again is set another streaming state, go to this drop down menu and click stop. Now, if we were to press the button as is, it would immediately start the stream and immediately stop the stream. The way we tell Touch Portal that we want it to start when we press it and then turn it off when we press it again is by using if logic statements. If we scroll back up in the action menu on the left, what we can do is create a if state action. If we drag this if state action up, what we can do is hit this drop down menu, select the OBS streaming state is, and if it is stopped. So essentially what we're telling Touch Portal is if OBS is not currently streaming, it will start the stream. The way we tell it to turn it on or off is by using an else action. The else action will sit right in between the start and stop function. With the else action, what we're telling Touch Portal now, if the stream isn't running, it will start the stream. Otherwise, it will stop the stream. That is how you use the if and else actions in Touch Portal. The next thing I want to show you how to do is create the button changes that happen with starting and stopping the stream. So you have the visual recognition on Touch Portal telling you whether you are streaming or not streaming. The way we do that is by going to the on event tab. On the on event tab, what we're going to use are the events from our action menu. If we scroll back down to our OBS section again, we can create an on streaming state event. The logic is the same as the if statements with the event statements. So when OBS is not streaming, what we want to do is change the button visuals to where we know that button is off. The way we do that is by scrolling back up in our actions on the left till we find our visuals. We want to create an action that changes the button visuals. What we're going to do is make sure that we have the changes we want made toggled here on the left. We're going to toggle a change icon too, and we're going to select the icon we want. Now we want to repeat the same event statements here when our stream is live. So what we can do is right click on this event here, copy, right click down here and paste that. What we'll do is change this from stopped over to started, and we will copy the action as well. Make sure you click it and drag it in between where it needs to be. Then we're going to change that icon visual to the on streaming button. Now you've successfully created an on and off switch for the button. The final step is to create the actual defaulted state of the button. Over on the right, we have the button settings. If we scroll down, we'll find the options for the icon. We can toggle this to a full size button or not a full size button. I prefer the full size button and the initial state of the button, whether that button is defaulted to off or defaulted to on. When you open OBS, your stream doesn't automatically start up. So the initial state of this button is off. So with that being said, we want to have the off button icon as our default icon. So we're going to change the button image here. And same thing, make sure we set it to that off icon. Once you have everything finished, you can quickly hit save here and it will save this button. Once you hit save on that button, you have successfully created an on and off switch for streaming in OBS. That's going to complete this tutorial. If you did like this video, do me a solid, hit that like button and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. In my next video, I'm going to show you guys how to use the move transition tool to move your webcam frame around the stream on one scene. So if you ever need to change the position of your webcam while you're streaming, you can do so on the fly at a touch of a button. So keep your eyes out for that in my next video. If you are interested in supporting supporting this channel and my Discord server, check out my Patreon at patreon.com/thefrancois. If you need any additional help with setting up Touch Portal, feel free to hop in my Discord server. We've got some pretty awesome Touch Portal guys in there who are ready to help you. Last but not least, if you like the YouTube thumbnail design for this video, I actually stream live on Twitch when I'm creating the YouTube thumbnails for my videos. So check out my Twitch channel at thefrancois. Thank you again so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.